Hi, in this video I want to show you how to use the Google Sketchup Photomatch process. So open up a new file, and this is Sketchup version 8. Go to File, Import, and I'm going to pick this two blocks and I'm going to use as new match photo. So I'm going to bring it in and it brings up my Photomatch system. And if I bring in my little dialog box, I have the spacing of the grid set at 5 feet right now. So that's okay, I'm going to leave it at that. This first block over here is 20 feet high, so I know that. So I'll just put that to the side. What do I want to do? Well, I want to put some of these on the perspective, and it's a two-point perspective. It's going this direction and that direction. So I'm going to take this red one, and I'm going to put it on these corners right here. Take this red one, and I'm just using my left mouse button to get it in a somewhat close position, and then I'm clicking on each corner and dragging it down. Taking the green ones, oops, I grabbed the red one by mistake, put it back, the green one, put it there, grab a corner, and we're just going to get it roughly in place to start with. And now you can see I have a bit of a photo match here, and this one here is the origin. So we can just say I want to make the origin, well, let's just make it this corner right here. Let's go right there. And we can zoom in a little better so we get a little closer. Let's see here. And I want the blue line to be straight up and down on this line, so I might have to just play around with a little bit, just to get it to bend. And you can see sometimes photos are not going to be exact, so you have to play around a little bit. And that's not bad. And you can see the grid, I have a 5 foot grid here, 5 feet, and I need to shrink it down because this is 20 feet high. So I can grab this on the red line, or I can do the green line. You just click on it and move it to the left to make it smaller, to the right to make it bigger, and let's put 4 grid points on there. You can see I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 grid spots. So that's 5, 10, 15, 20 feet high. And it puts the person in the right perspective. I'm pretty close on the line. I know I'm off a little bit, but you got to match the photos as best you can. So let's say these are two buildings now. I've got it sort of set up for the photo match, and I can just close it. And now I want to put a building in here. So I can just click, and you got to be careful that you stay on the axes. Here's the red axis. And let's say I'm going to go to here, and then I'm going to go in the green and put in a building that's, well, let's make it 30 feet long. Then I want to make it 20 feet wide. And then I'll connect it back up. Make sure you're on the axis. And you should be able to bring it up. Maybe I'm going to put a 50-foot building in. And the reason it's kind of see-through there is the way it works in version 8. Version 7 doesn't do this, but version 8, you have to go to Windows, Styles, and I'll click Styles. I have it over here on another screen. Go to Edit, and then you go to this blue one right here, the model setting, and the foreground photo, you have to click on that. And right now you can change how opaque it is. I just turn it off, and there's my model. So in the styles, that's the trick you got to remember. And you can turn off the background photo. You can make it a little less opaque. That's in the styles under model settings. All right, what good is this? Okay, so now I have a building. Let's say I had a photograph that had a building here and a building here. I could go in now and say I'm going to put a building in for a client, and I can work on the building. I can give it texture, bricks, and I can just work on it and put on a roof on it, let's say. And when I hit two blocks, that's the name of the photo match, it'll go right back and I can print it out. And I can use this and insert it with a photo imaging package, or I can print it right out using SketchUp. I can show you one trick, like if you already had this as a building in a photograph, you can do a really quick sketch of the building. Approximately there. All right, I missed one edge. Get the rubber banding, go down. And if I Photomatch back on, yeah, it's a really rough drawing, but let's say I just make my building and I go back to Photomatch. Well, it's kind of rough, but let's say I select the whole thing. Well, let's just select this building here, this new cube that I made. Now, if you go back to Match Photo and you project textures from photo, yes, sure. And what it did, excuse me, it took my photo and put the image from the photo, the background photo, on my new square. So I'd have, if this was a building picture, it would show all the shapes of the building. And then I could print this out, showing my new building concept and some of the neighborhood. So this is really quick how to match photos. So try and line up the different axis of the photo match and see if you can draw a building in between the two blocks.